ex-stockbroker Peter first met keen photographer Anne by chance in their hometown, Lyon-Sea.
I work as a private chartered physiotherapist from home. I'm also an acupuncturist.
I had pretty bad back pain, and my GP said that there was this young, attractive physiotherapist who started in Lyon, and perhaps she could be quite good for me. Anyway, I booked an appointment, and she sorted my back out.
Yep, 14 years ago.
Was it that long?
Friends for many years, love blossomed after they volunteered for the Endeavour Trust, a charity which maintains this historic fishing boat, which was used in the Dunkirk rescue and recently featured in the award-winning film.
We're both widowed and we got married 2 months ago. We are delighted that we've had a second chance at love and incredibly happy together. We absolutely can't wait to move down to Devon. We're really looking forward to exploring the beaches with my camera. We're looking forward to going for walks with the dogs on the beach, always ending up in a pub. Pete wants to find a golf course with a good view looking out over the sea.
You know, Anne likes caddying for me and cleaning my clubs. Not.
In his dreams, he imagines me caddying for him.
They've had their eye on the Devon property market for 2 years, but now that they're wed and Peter's house is sold, it's the right time to make their move.
We've viewed a number of properties, probably 20 to 30 properties, and some of them have been really wonderful, but we just haven't been in a situation where we can actually say, this is the house that we want.
And now is the right time for us to plan our move and make our move and start our new life together.
So what is it about this area that you love so much?
We love the beaches, beautiful seascapes, and the fact we can bring the dogs onto the beach, the proximity to Dartmoor as well, the lovely villages.
The people,
definitely the people, the pubs.
In fact, pubs?
I don't think we've got a negative to say about South Devon.
It's all encompassing on a positive level, though. I like the sound of this. Mm. And you guys have got a healthy budget of 1 million, possibly 1.2 if you find, you know, a property that you really love.
Yep.
So what are you looking for in terms of a property? What would be your absolute ideal?
We'd like a property with land between 1 and 5 acres because we'd like to have chickens and goats and let the dogs run free, detached, at least 4 bedrooms. I work from home as a physiotherapist, so I'd like space to work with a separate entrance.
Space for the motorhome is important.
Space for the motorhome, yes. We have a motorhome that's currently off-site, so we'd like to have it close to the home so that we can keep an eye on it.
Any other must-haves?
Well, near the sea.
That's a big thing, really, isn't it? You've got to be close to the sea moving down here.
And also walking distance or cycling distance to a pub.
OK.
And a golf course. Reasonably close.
There are a lot of things here, guys.
Well, we didn't want to make it too easy for you.
You definitely haven't. You definitely haven't. There's a lot on that list, so I think we better get started. Let's go.
For our third property, we're heading west to Averton Gifford, right by the River Avon, an area of outstanding natural beauty, renowned for wild swimming in summer months. At the mouth of the river lies Bantham, often referred to as one of Europe's best beaches. And just a short drive away is this 4-bedroom stone barn conversion with a separate 2-bedroom cottage for Anne's practice and 1.8 acres of land for the chickens and goats. All within budget at just shy of £900,000, so I'm feeling pretty confident.
Right, some fun facts about this property for you. You've got a coastal path just round the corner, so really good for walking the dogs. It's around a mile walk to the nearest pub. You've also got sea views just here,
yeah.
So the sea really isn't far.
Lovely.
Excellent.
And this is the property. And I kind of got from the last one that we saw that you like that quirky look.
Absolutely, yeah.
Well, this is a former cow shed. Some of the walls actually date back to the 16th century. It was converted in the 1980s.
I like the stone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah, it's very attractive.
As well as this, you've got a 2-bedroom separate annex. Current owners are using it as a holiday let at the moment, so they're getting around £1,200 per week in peak season.
That's
but
good.
Talking about having that separate area, could be used for your business and could be used for family and friends to come and stay.
Okay.
And that was actually a form of piggery.
Right, okay.
So you've got a cow shed and a piggery.
That's very good. You'll feel quite at home, darling.
Shocking. Shocking. Shall we go in and have a look, Peter?
While I still can walk
here. Quick. Come in. Now, you've got a great area back there to hang up your coats, boots, things for the dogs.
Yeah.
It's really grand, isn't it? Do you like that kind of
thing?
It's
cool. Yeah, I like it.
Again, an unusual layout with this property. So you've got four bedrooms, three of which are downstairs, and then you've got a master bedroom and the living area upstairs.
OK.
But your kitchen is on the ground floor and just through here.
OK.
Let's see that first. This is a lovely, colourful kitchen. How do you think it rates in comparison to the other two that we've seen?
I think I probably like it best, actually.
Really?
Yes.
Well, it's so light, isn't it?
Yeah, I like the colour. I like the colour of the cupboards. I like the range.
And I think it's lovely having these double doors that open out onto a terrace. As you said, it lets the light in. You know, the sun's coming through. You're liking the vibe, Peter?
Yes, I am. No, I like the kitchen. It's good size as well.
You up for seeing some more of the house?
Yes.
Let's
indeed.
Go.
Indeed.
So, like with your last property that we saw, you've got your living space upstairs.
That's lovely.
Yeah, it's cosy. Like the beams.
I like all the bookshelves. We've got a lot of books, so that would work.
And you did say in the last property that you didn't mind having bedrooms downstairs, living space upstairs. Do you feel the same with this one?
Yeah.
No, we don't mind upstairs, downstairs. It doesn't matter.
Well, that's good, because once you've finished chilling on your sofa, it's just a very, very short stroll to the master suite.
OK.
So this is your main bedroom.
It's nice. I like it. I'm not so sure about the beams over the bed. Feng shui, it's like blades cutting down onto you.
Oh, I see. Right. What are you thinking, Peter? You're having a good old look around there.
Perfectly honest, it's not doing much for me.
Is it not?
No, it's not like a bedroom.
Well, don't worry, because there are still three bedrooms downstairs. You can go and have a look at those in a bit and see if one of those might work for you as a master bedroom. Before you do that, though, I just want to show you one quick thing outside.
OK.
Obviously, there's the two-bed annex, which is separate from the property, which I want you to have a look at, but I wanted to show you this first of all. Another outbuilding, and it's already got planning permission granted, ready to go for a home office with a mezzanine level, two Velux windows and a log burner in here.
Ooh. This would be fine for a treatment room and a small office area.
To get it all decked out, it would cost around £20,000. Did you notice the grape plant growing outside as well? You could start a whole new business of crushing grapes and making wine. Right, there's still a lot more to see, so go and take a look at the annex, then the other bedrooms, and we'll catch up later. I'll tell you the price.
OK.
See you in a bit.
This is nice. Much bigger than I thought it would be. Shall we have a look upstairs?
Why not?
They've managed to put three beds in here.
Yes.
So how is this property measuring up to the last ones that you've seen?
I think it's our least favourite. We liked the kitchen and the lounge, but we really didn't like the bedrooms, any of them. The annex, which could be a holiday let, was a lovely place.
The decoration of the two-bed cottage was possibly better than the house that we're living in.
Yeah.
That we would be living in. And
I mean, you could decorate the house as well, Peter, you know, and bring it up to scratch. Yeah.
But if I'm not loving the house, it's a non-starter.
Yeah, that's totally true. You've got to, when you walk into a place, you've got to feel it, haven't you? Well, it's on the market. I'm not sure this is going to sway you. It's on the market for
£895. Really?
Yeah. Do you think that's just because you really didn't feel the vibe of it?
I'm sure that sways it.
It comes with land. It's got, you know, outbuildings, and it's got that working annex as a business, but it's got to work for you.
Yeah.
But we've got another property to see, the final one, so I think we should make a move.
Okay.
Thank you.